Okay, so I'm a coast guard and I'm currently stationed in Kodiak, Alaska. I live in a barracks. And I was cleaning my barracks room today and I pulled out my armoire to vacuum behind it when I found this notebook. I took a look at it and it's a journal. I figured it might be interesting to check out another guy's Kodiak experience. So I started reading it. I read about a month's worth of entries and it definitely the kind of thing that belongs here on Reddit No Sleep. There's a good amount of jargon, so I've taken the liberty of adding in a few explanations, mostly for the abbreviations. My notes are enclosed in brackets. Everything else I've typed as is was written. 1st of January 2012. I reported to my new unit today, Air Station Kodiak, Alaska. I'm really excited. Of all the units I could get sent to, I'd get the one with the TV show about it. If you told me 10 years ago that I'd be living in Alaska fixing machine guns for a living, I'd laughed in your face. Just goes to show you never really know what's coming, I guess. Anyway, my new boss, GM1 Roberts, gunner's mate first class, picked me up at the airport this morning, and it's a tiny airport too. There's only one gate and baggage claim is a window that they drop my suitcase through. GM1 is a really nice guy. He helped me with my bags, took me out to breakfast, then drove me around and gave me a tour of the town and the base. We finished up the tour at the barracks, where GM1 helped bring my bags to the front office and then left with a hearty, "See you in the morning." Since it's Sunday, they don't have a permanent room for me yet. But they got me set up with a bed in a squad bay, a big room with multiple beds, in the basement. And the guy at the front desk said I should get a room by tomorrow. I was a little worried at first because the squad bay has like 20 beds in it. But there's only two other guys staying in here right now, so we all have plenty of room. I'm really looking forward to starting work tomorrow and to get my own room. One of the other guys in here just went to sleep and snoring. 2nd of January 2012. First day at work today. I think I'm really going to like it here. I didn't get to do any actual work. I spent most of the time walking around in my dress blues, checking in with the various people. The commanding officer, the command master chief, the command drug and alcohol representative, my division officer, etc. We also got to meet all of the other people in my shop. Everyone here seemed really nice. When I introduced myself with GM3 Fredrickson, gunner's mate third class, they were like, "No man, what's your first name?" And that was that. Everyone here goes by their first name except GM1 and the lieutenant. But even they call everyone by their first name. So here's the basic structure of our shop. Collectively, we are the weapons division. The division officer, Lieutenant Burke, is in charge of us all. Within the division, there are two teams, Armory and Airborne Use of Force. Airborne Use of Force, or AUF, is made up of about 8 guys, AMTs and AETs, Aviation Maintenance Technicians and Avionics / Electrical Technicians. Respectively, whose job it is to fly around in helicopters and shoot them. I'm in the Armory. GM1 Roberts is in charge of us, under him is GM2 Jameson, and then me. We do maintenance and repair on the weapons the AUF guys use, and we also handle all the ammo and give basic marksmanship training to new AUF gunners. All in all, it seemed like a pretty badass way to make a living. I'm looking forward to starting some actual work tomorrow. Anyway, after work, I got checked into my very own room in the barracks. I lucked out to rooms in the main building of 2 beds, no alcohol is allowed. But I managed to get a room in the 21 and up building, which is down the road a little from the main building. The rooms there only have 1 bed, can have alcohol in the room. I'm glad I managed to get in here, not just because it means I get to have a beer after work without having to walk through the snow. See, the main building is recently renovated, so it has a sterile clinical feel. Like you'd expect from a military building, fluorescent lights, long straight hallway, white walls and ceilings, and that blue carpet with the little red and white flecks you always see in public buildings. It feels more like a human resource storage facility than a home. Barracks 8, my building, on the other hand, hasn't been renovated since it was built in the 1980s, and with the government always being about 10 years behind the times, it has a really homey 70s feel to it. The carpets are softer and a darker shade of blue. The walls are beige on top and green on the bottom, with a little wood panel separating the two colours. There's a nice living room with some couches on each of the two floors. On the second floor, there's a kitchen with a full-size oven and fridge, a deep freezer in case you bag any deer or fish, a dining table, pool table, poker table, and a stereo system. There's even an old-school wood-paneled mechanical vending machine on the first floor hallway. My actual room is nice too. The bed is relatively soft, and instead of the usual itchy grey wool blanket, they gave me a soft green warm comforter. There's a small recliner, desk and chair, a nightstand, two dressers, an armoire, a mini fridge, and a microwave. There's even a bathroom between every two bedrooms with a door on either side so you can get in from either room. And the toilet is in a little stall so your neighbour can come in to use the sink or the shower without having to watch you take a dump. Definitely a plus. The only weird thing is, in order to save space in the bedrooms, they built the bathroom sticking out into the hall a little bit, so the whole hall follows a zigzag pattern. Added to the old incandescent lights being a little dim and some of them being out altogether, the overall effect is a little odd. You can't see from one end of the hall to the other. In fact, you can't see more than 8 or 10 feet in either direction because of the curves. Okay, so I finished writing the last paragraph and then went out to have a smoke. It's only like 6 o'clock, but since it's January in Alaska, it's dark around 4, so it was pitch black outside except for the little light above the door. While I was out there smoking, the door on the second floor opens and this guy steps out onto the porch and just stands there. He doesn't light up a smoke or go downstairs to the parking lot or anything, he just stands there. And then as I'm looking at him, I realise I can't see him very well because the porch light is behind him and he's being backlit right up. But I think he's looking at me. No, staring. He's just standing there totally still. And the longer I look at him, the more sure I am that he's staring back at me. I wave at him and he doesn't move. He just stands there, staring. So I stand there looking back at him for so long my cigarette goes out. I go to relight it and when I look back up, the dude is gone. No tracks in the snow. I didn't hear the door open. He's just gone. So I put out my cigarette, even though there was some left, and I come back inside. I don't know what's up with that guy, but it's so weird and unsettling. I had to write it down. I double checked and made sure that the front door to my room and the door to the bathroom and the window were all locked. And they are. What a weirdo. Oh well, I guess no place is perfect. 3rd of January 2012. First day of actual work today. GM2 and I took apart and cleaned some machine guns that the AUF guy brought to the range last week. It was fun and I learned a lot of little tricks on how to get them clean, but man, I'm tired. I got woken up at like 2 in the morning last night by some butthole stomping around the hallway upstairs. First I thought it was probably some drunk dude stumbling back to his room. It is the 21 and over building after all. But he didn't ever really go anywhere, just stomped from one end of the hallway to the other and then back again. Back and forth, back and forth. Really annoying. And I couldn't get back to sleep. After about 10 minutes of relentless stomping, I finally decided to go up there and give the guy a piece of my mind. But as soon as I sat up, I heard the side door open and close. Then the guy stomped down the outside stairs and I guess he left because I didn't hear him anymore. And I fell back asleep a few minutes later. But man, being woken up like that can really mess up a good night's sleep. What was that guy up to anyway? Just back and forth for 10 minutes and then he leaves. Walked out into the snow at 2 in the morning. I didn't hear a car start up, so did he just walk out into the night? I wonder if it was that same weirdo who was staring at me earlier. 5th of January 2012. I heard that stomping again last night, around midnight this time. I listened to it for about 5 minutes before deciding to go upstairs and talk some sense into the guy. So I threw on a shirt and my slippers and walked down the hall to the stairs. I could hear the guy stomping the whole time, but once I got up to the second floor, I couldn't find him. There was no one up there. I went from one end of the hall to the other and nobody was there. No doors were open, nobody was in the living room or the kitchen, nothing. If I ever catch this phantom stomper, I'm going to ruin his fucking evening, I swear. 6th of January 2012, Friday, first week of a new job is over. I didn't hear the stomping guy last night and I actually got a good night's sleep. There's a bar on base right down the road from the barracks. I'm going to meet some guys from the shop there later and have a couple of beers. 8th of January 2012, okay, this is getting weird. Just a minute ago there was a knock at my door. I got up, answered it, There was nobody out there. I stepped out into the hall and no one was around. But then I noticed that there was some snow tracks on the carpet. The tracks went from the side door to my room and then back again. I know they're not mine, because I always wipe my boots really well to avoid tracking snow all over. But here's the weird part. The carpet in front of the door to my room was soaking wet. I can't be sure, but it seemed like whoever knocked on my door just stood in front of it for a really long time. Long enough for some of the snow on their jacket or whatever to fall off the carpet and melt. But then, as soon as they knocked, they left without waiting for me to answer the door. Someone was fucking with me, and I don't appreciate it. 13th of January 2012. I'm starting to get the hang of things at work, and I'm falling into a routine. I hope this job, and I'm good at it, but we're going to the range next week, and I'm looking forward to it. I told GM1 I'm not a very good shot, and he promised he would help me get my expert medal before summer. I haven't had any more issues with the stomping, or knocking, or staring. I hear there's a guy at work who's trying to sell his Ford Bronco. I'm going to take a look at it next week. Hopefully I can take it off his hands and go a little more of the island. 18th of January 2012. There's this shed kind of between the sides of the barracks building and the smoking area. I was outside smoking a minute ago and I looked up and saw someone standing by the shed facing me. It was dark. I couldn't see him very well, but I'm sure it was the same guy from before. I'm sure he was staring at me again. I'd had enough. I walked straight over there with Aiden and put my cigarette out because I didn't want him to vanish again. As I was walking towards him, he stepped behind the shed and asked a view. I followed him round the side of the shed and he was gone. The tracks went round to the back of it and then just stopped. Like he fucking teleported away. I looked around for a minute before deciding to go back to the smoking area and finish my cigarette. There's a little shack so you don't have to get rained or snowed on while you smoke. I was about halfway to it, I saw him step out of the shack and start walking towards me. I don't know how I got over there so fast without leaving any tracks in knee-deep snow. I wanted to go over there and clock him, but the way he was walking, pushing his way through the piled up snow so quickly, so purposefully, I had lost my nerve, flicked my cigarette into the snow and went the hell back inside. When I was almost back to my room, he started pounding on the side door, the one I had just entered the building through. Not knocking, I mean pounding, hard. The whole door was shaking in its frame. I just stood there for a few seconds, not sure what to do. And then one of the guys down the hall came out of his room and said, "What the fuck?" And the pounding just stopped. He asked me if I knew what that was about. I told him what happened and we called the front desk to complain, but nobody answered. I don't know what this fucking guy's deal is, but I'm starting to get a little scared. 19th of January 2012. I bought that Bronco today. After all that's been going on, I needed to get away from the barracks for a while. So I talked to my buddy Jack to go and camp this weekend. Rented a tent and stuff from the MWR, Moral Welfare and Recreation. Bought some beer and food and firewood. We're leaving tomorrow and coming back on Sunday. Jack says he knows a good spot where there won't be a lot of people around, so we can set up all targets. Shooting without having to worry about shooting into another campsite by hand. 22nd of January 2012. That campsite is exactly what I need. I'd realised how much this situation with this weird guy had put me on edge until I actually got a chance to put some distance between myself and Barracks 8 and relax. I actually had a great time. Jack and I sat around the fire, we got a little bit drunk on Friday night, talking stories about SAR cases, search and rescue we'd been on, and girls we'd screwed, our job before the Coast Guard. Saturday morning after breakfast we hiked through the woods around our campsite to make sure there wasn't anyone else around, then set up beer bottles from the night before and took turns shooting at them. Then today we hiked a little more before breaking camp and coming back to base. I dropped Jack off at his house, he's married so he gets an actual house, and came back to the barracks for a nice long hot shower. I'm going to go to bed early tonight and then try to figure out what I'm going to do about this weird guy tomorrow. 23rd of January 2012. This afternoon when I came home from work, I saw my next door neighbour, the one I shared my bathroom with, going into his room with some luggage. I asked him if he was going on leave and he said no, he was just coming back. He had gone to Anchorage for over the weekend with some friends for a snowboarding trip. I asked him how the trip was and he said it was good. We said goodbye and went into our respective rooms. Here's the thing. Yesterday evening while I was in the shower, I heard the door leading from my neighbour's room into our shared bathroom open. I heard him walk over to the sink, turn on the water. He ran the water for a couple of minutes. It sounded like he was washing his face or something. He then shut off the water, went back into his room, and closed and locked the door. I didn't think anything of it at the time, but if he was in Anchorage all weekend, and he just got back today, then... Who the hell came into the bathroom last night? Well, that's all I've read through so far. I need to get to bed. I have work in the morning. But honestly, I'm kind of creeped out by this. I'm the new GM3 at Air Station Kodiak. I work in the weapons division, the same shop this Fredrickson guy worked in. Could this journal be written by the guy I replaced? I'm going to have a look through the file cabinet tomorrow and see what I can find. I'll throw out an update once I've typed up some more of the journal. Probably tomorrow or the next day. In the meantime, let me know what you think.